Between June 6th and July 16th, 2012, more than 132,000 acres of sagebrush steppe across southern Idaho were consumed by wildland fire. The complex ecological relationship between sagebrush and wildland fire is in the spotlight this year, as the BLM works to keep the greater sage-grouse off the list of threatened and endangered species. Conserving remaining sage-grouse habitat, the agency believes, is the way to conserve the species and the key to continuing to manage sage lands for multiple use. Identifying intact habitat is the first step in conserving it. Nearly three-quarters of the prime sagebrush habitat lost in Idaho so far this year burned in just 9 days in two large fires. Restoring sagebrush can take much longer.
With larger and larger fires, the potential for natural dispersal has decreased exponentially. It's gotten to the place where it just plain doesn't come back naturally unless you're in higher elevations where you have like intermittent unburned communities.
Even before a fire is fully contained, interdisciplinary teams of resource specialists begin planning how to treat and restore burned areas.
The challenge that faces the ID team is to look at the important resources, look at the condition, determine what absolutely needs assistance to meet objectives for managing a healthy resource, and then to put the puzzle together to figure out how those treatments will be placed on the ground in a way that makes ecological sense and financial sense.
Reseeding or replanting with native vegetation is the standard treatment, but with some areas reburning at much shorter intervals, slow-growing plants like sagebrush may not have time to reestablish or grow tall enough to serve as habitat before the next fire. For some areas that have burned this year, the BLM will explore additional techniques for enhanced long-term protection of public lands and the resources they hold.